Greetings to the Earthlings, welcome to Blackthorne, also known as Blackhawk in some areas of the world. I don't know exactly where, but yeah, this is essentially a DOS game. I'm playing it on DOS, I mean, this game has also been released for the NES. However, well, I actually first played this game back in like 2004 or 5. And yeah, I just wanted to play it through to the end, because I never got the chance to do that as a child. So yeah, without further ado, let's go ahead and begin a new game then. Sarlac's keep deep in the heart of Tuul. Holy shit, this guy looks bad. As in badass. Gargoyles as well to the sides. What is your bidding, sire? King Vlaros makes his last stand tonight at Stonefist. Go now. Stonefist, south of the borderlands, armies are marching into it and setting it ablaze. That is, I suppose, the King of Vlaros. Farewell, my son. He gets teleported. I remember that day well. My father's last words forever echoing in my mind. Gaio, my son, you must seek the light soon and hide among the Earthlings. Guard it with your life, for if it should fall into Sarlac's evil hands, all will be lost. With time, you will grow strong, and someday you will return to Tuul to fulfill your destiny. One thing that I like about this game is the fact that they don't make the dialogues go by fast. They wait for your prompt before doing that. Oh wait. That was 20 years ago, and they gave you lots of time to read at least, unlike Elder Scrolls Arena. So basically, I don't know if I skipped some part of the story there, but the basic story is pretty simple. This guy is Kyle. He was sent to Earth to hide among the Earthlings, and now that he actually underwent basic military training there, and now that he's back onto, I think, Vlaros, or whatever the name of the place was, he's now coming to free the Androthi. These guys are actually Androthi, they're not humans or Earthlings. And his basic job is to essentially free the enslaved people of Androthi, I think, of planet Androthi. Save yourself while there is still time. This game has platform mechanics similar to Prince of Persia, where things are very precise. Could it be? Are you the chosen one? Chosen one, huh? I see there are myths spreading about me already. Seems we don't need to pull out a gun just yet, but it's always better to do so. Oh, said the Androthi. So that is a hover bomb, and we can use these to blast through doors. Time to equip my gun. Oh wait, I never went to the next section. And you basically need to hide from the orcs while you're shooting them, otherwise you can die. You can die quite easily in this game. Another hover bomb. Now we can take the ladder, or we can just take these ledges here and see with how that fares. No enemies on this side, but I do see something on the other side. I don't know what it is, but there certainly is something on the other side. I'm not going to discharge my gun in fear of hurting my fellow Androthi that I'm here to save. I could probably free that guy as well. Free at last! Take this potion, brother. Thank you, friend. Says Kyle. Only one way through. This level is actually divided into multiple segments. Oh, we need to unequip our gun to go through this door, which is sort of strange. Now then, can we make this jump? That guy's willing to fight. Now, the way that combat in this game works is that you need to, like, essentially dodge the enemy. Yep. I was afraid of that happening, but the one fatal flaw that these orcs have is that they gloat every single time they get a successful shot on you. And you can use that to your advantage to take them out. Yeah, you never can be quick enough to dodge the orcs when they try and attack. And this is how this goes, the firefights in this game, I mean. At least you have infinite ammo, so that's something. I don't think we'll need to take a running head start on this. And I fell. So this is what I was talking about when I said that the controls in this game are really precise. This guy dropped another hover bomb. I am sort of concerned for my health at this point in time. But I also do have a health potion, which I will use, definitely. Just getting a bit of a safe range from that. Explosion there. The game has been saved, which is a good sign. To escape bombs, it is better to avoid them than to be nimble. Basically, dodge. Oh, this guy shoots as well. Apparently, they take multiple shots to down these red guys. And I automatically consumed my potion of health. That is amazing. That is pretty good, actually. No enemies on this side. There's definitely nothing on the other side, so might as well just drop down instead. Now, you can just blind fire into the next area, but it is a bad idea, because if there are any fellow Androthi around, you're gonna get them as well. And the thing about these goblins is that, or orcs or whatever they are, is that if they get too close to you, they can attack you as well. Some waterfalls have passages behind them. Look closely. I shall keep an eye out. I could definitely use that. Now, before I go there, I'll wait for that guy to shoot a shot. Once these guys are in melee range, you really cannot dodge them. So it's best to just... So I guess this is the way back up. I suppose we cannot go there. I see what's going on here. There's like a beastmaster over there. If only I had a bomb, I could escape that guard. Yeah, right. So, those guys, they use their whip to attack you. And the only way to defeat them really is to use the bomb instead. They're invulnerable to, well, anything else. Power to the Androthi. Take this bomb. Thank you, friend. Did I see something there? Bridge key. Alright. That'll probably come in handy. Like, you can mostly duck out of the way of shotgun blasts as well, but that is not what I meant to do at all. I'm still getting a hang of the controls for this game. Platforming sections are going to be my biggest issue. I'm just gonna keep this equipped. Now, this game actually has checkpoints, but it has no... How do I put this? Nothing here. Might not have been the case if we had gone the other way though. But who knows what the other way held. I wonder if there's a path upstairs. Yep, there seems to be. Nothing here though, except for the store. If you want to escape, blow out the power generator with this bomb. Thank you, friend. I wonder what a prisoner was doing with a bomb in his pocket. How did they miss that? Okay, so there are two paths that we can take. I wonder what happened there. Maybe I double tapped the arrow button. Is what happened. The laser fields keep us trapped and it is hopeless. I wonder if this is a ledge. It is. It most certainly is a ledge. I wonder what this Androthi has to say. I slipped something into his rations. He's out cold. Well, he seems dead. He's not just out cold, he's dead. Oh yeah, right. Should have taken my shot while I had the chance. So once these guys get into melee range, they can hit you even if you're hiding away in the shadows. So it's best to just try and get them. Timing is key in this game, needless to say. And you never know how many shots they're going to take. This is going to be a long drawn out fight. I took it deep. Miss again. The problem is you never know how many shots they're gonna fire at you. Oh cool, so I can actually maneuver the elevator with the gun drawn. Oh no, I accidentally unequipped. I pressed the F button instead of the S button. I made a fatal mistake in doing so. One hit in. Two hits in. Cool. Yeah. Right, I need to holster my weapon before I can climb. Oh yeah, you can do that as well, can't you? Alright, the force fields are now deactivated. Using the ladder, like a good little lad. Now, since I know that the other side has an enemy and no civilians, I can just go ahead and shoot him from here itself. Which apparently did nothing. Too late though. As soon as you hear him cocking, go ahead and shoot him. Might as well use this. I don't know if I'm gonna automatically heal or not, but might as well use it while I can. I've been retrying this section for some time now. Some waterfalls or passages behind them, look closely. This thing in front of us is a trap. It's gonna deploy a... how do I put this? A machine gun. Which spawns from the ceiling. If we go down here, we can actually find some elixir for ourselves. However... whoops, not the key that I wanted to press. I'm just used to the WASD controls. There's gonna be a bad guy up ahead. We'll need a levitator to get up there. If only I could steal Levitator. Next section is a bad guy that needs eliminating. Too late. One hit. Two hits. Well, I am getting better in this game, at this game. So, with that having been done, the next section has this key guy who wants like an elevator key. But before that, we need to jump down here, grab this elixir. We don't need to, but I sort of feel safer with it in my hands. Alright. Running jump over onto this side. There's like a spike pit down there. And we do have like a bridge key, but I do not want to use it because this bridge leads nowhere. It's a dead end. So it's sort of a waste. This guy is looking for an elevator call switch. This section is clear and there's literally nowhere else to go, which makes me believe that perhaps what I'm looking for is in another part of the map. So maybe this game isn't as linear as I thought it to be. So we're gonna have to backtrack our way a little. This waterfall, by the way, does not have any entrances behind it. I know because I've already checked. Now we need to be careful not to step on the plate there. I'll just jump over to the other side, thank you. And back down we go. Wait, I can't go down? What? How am I supposed to proceed then? This is strange. Does this place have like an entrance behind it or something? I cannot see any. And I don't even have any bombs to like verify whether it does or not. This is a bridge key, which gets me nothing. First mission of the game and I'm already stuck. This does not fare well. If only I could steal the levitator, then I could get up there, couldn't I? What about this waterfall though? Does it have an entrance behind it? Apparently not. Didn't think it would, does not seem any different than the other waterfalls as compared to the other waterfalls. This guy only had that one thing and all you can do at this point is just drop down this shaft, which kills you instantly. I mean, the only thing that remains at this point is to maybe use the bridge key somehow. And I've got no idea why I might want to do that because there's literally nothing else to do here. Is there an entrance there? Oh, there is! Holy hell. This guy is eager to talk to me. Free at last! Take this potion, brother. Thank you, friend. Thank you indeed. Maybe this is a... I don't know what it did, but it did something. I'm guessing that spawns the elevator. Let's go ahead and talk to this guy now. I'm looking for the elevator's call switch. Yes, yes it does. Well, the elevator call switch was right there. But this thing actually goes lower. But I just sort of wanted to get here first. Those guys won't be able to harm us because... Curse Sarlac. Yeah, we need to destroy the power generators first. Problem in engaging in a shootout with those guys over here is the fact that... Now, the proper way to go would probably be the right. Yep, that guy said. That is really where I wanted to go. Upstairs. If only I could get by the laser fields. Do either of you have a bomb for me though? That will what? Someday our people will be free. Indeed. But I can see the power generator with no way to get up there. I'm guessing I'll need some sort of a drone bomb of some sort. This guy's gonna die, yep. Yeah, I did not want to get into a shootout with my fellow Androthi around, but there's seemingly no other way to go about it. I want to talk to this guy first before I check out the waterfall. Maybe there's something behind this. The bridge keys can be reused in any bridge. Oh, so I'll have to go back and get the bridge key then? Maybe. This waterfall has nothing behind it. Yeah, that's a trap. I know a trap when I see one. Let's just jump past it. There's nothing on the side on the right. Might as well jump up here. Use the ladder, or maybe just... Okay, we need to use the ladder. No way to actually get on the ledge. Okay, I see enemies. Now, it is sort of my responsibility to make sure that this guy is dead before we can get a shot off on my fellow Androthi right here. But I know that is asking the impossible. And I got hit in the process. How nice. Got him while he was ducking. I got a vial of health, but I don't know if I'd really want it or not. Cool. You actually need to face the direction in which you're headed if you want to get to it. Holy shit, that is a bomb! I see. Might as well go ahead and use this potion then. And we'll need this bomb to take out this guy. You're dead. Congratulations. Wait, you have something for me. It's another bomb! Yay! I wonder if those are force fields or if they're being forced to mine. Guns are heavily armored but can be destroyed. Really? I guess I'll have to use bombs for them. F key. Remember to use the F key instead. I hope this guy does not move towards me. Well, he's dead. Ah, removed war, spicy. Oh, I accidentally hit my friend there. Oh no. Yeah. That guy said. Do you have anything for me then? Apparently not. So I guess we use this remote wasp to go ahead and take out the power generator in the other level. Alright, headed back. Need to holster the weapon again. Alright. A lot of platforming. Trap avoided. I do not know what the trap was, but I have avoided it. Pretty sure I can't make the jump. Oh, I did. Nice. Poor Androthi. I wish I could have given them their freedom, but it seems to be a pretty difficult task. Now, I don't know how this is going to work, but here we go. I hope I do not accidentally bump into something and cause an explosion. E again? Ah, cool. That was a long way around. Alright then, let's go level up and get those other guys. Well, this is going to be an ugly fight, and a lot of Androthi are going to lose their lives. One hit onto you. Too slow. I basically need to take the one out on the front first. Yeah, that's something that tends to happen. Yep, that's the problem with having to fight multiple Androthi. I just mashed my button there. Okay, so we need to get that bridge key back if you want to progress. If you want to make progress. Alright, let's go up and get that bridge key then. That'll enable us to get the levitator, which we need to exit the space. Cool. Alright. We can run everywhere, but I do not prefer running because it takes up a lot of health. Sorry, it's difficult to control your own momentum when you're running. Pretty sure there was something down there, but yeah, I'm not really interested in the collectathon right now. I accidentally fired a shot. Let's hope I did not hit an Androthi. Missed. Looting pig. Missed again. Missed again. I see the path forward. Gave me some opportunity to shoot him there. Now I wonder if there's like a secret passage behind this waterfall, because why else would you want to go down there, I wonder. Maybe it's like a failsafe for us to not die, you know, in case we miss the jump. The game is just being generous with us for now. Alright, let's attempt this. Yep, it was a failsafe and I totally needed that. Basically, if you want to jump, do it like one step before. Like every time you want to issue a command, do it one step before the actual command itself. Alright, and she holds the weapon too. Okay, so that thing is a levitator. Now I know what to do. Last time I tried to pick it up, it just boosted me up into the air. Which is why I was confused about what to do. Okay, should I just go ahead and pop in one of these? Might as well, right? In case we fail this, like I thought I would. So there are no other hidden entrances, just that levitator thing. And I also did figure out how to, since I'm done with this, might as well just keep it with me. I guess you need to see Hulz if you want to have any kind of a chance to, you know, pick stuff up from the ground. Otherwise, it just does not work. Perhaps I could use it here, I think. Seems like a suitable option. I guess not. Okay, you need to get up, sir. Okay, let us go and use this here then. It's strange how this thing works. So, you've got a levitator, but you still need to figure out how to break free from those chains. Good thing I brought the bridge key along, because I would have needed it here. There seems to be a way towards the left as well, but I haven't taken it yet. I don't know if I'm gonna take it, but yeah. Galadril waits for you in the upper catacombs. Take this potion to aid you. Thank you, friend. Well, as long as I'm getting potions, I suppose. Galadril. Really sounds like a very elvish kind of a name. I hope I do not destroy that guy using the bomb. That would suck. If you are caught, you will be punished. No shit. My plan is to not be caught. Too late. All right. He gave us a bomb in case we needed one, but little did he know that we did not need the bomb. We were doing just fine on our own. Curse Sarlac! Curse him indeed. Okay, do you have anything for me? Apparently not. Let us talk to you first. If only I could escape. Yeah, I wonder what's keeping you. Maybe those chains, those laser chains that you have on your hands. That could be the reason why you can't escape. So we got two ways to go here. Let's try going up, I suppose. So, this is essentially the new day. Missed. And I've been trying to get past this next section for a while now, but I've just been unable to for the most part. He's dead. Now, if the graphics look a little different, I don't know whether they look any different or not, but if they do look a little different, it's because I'm using this software called Tossbox Staging to play this game right now. That's a bridge key that I can use. Since I'll not be utilizing my previous curse this terrible life footage, I'll let me just go ahead and talk to these people again. I have actually played past this part. I've reached the place that I need to reach. Maybe, have you seen my brothers? They're hiding. Yeah, so basically, if you recall, at the very beginning of the level, there's this guy who's essentially chained up, and oh no, I already lost health. And so basically, I've talked to that guy as well without any issues. So, like, I've gone through the door that's next to that guy. Why am I sucking so hard right now? Maybe it's the lack of practice. I mean, I could get through this section pretty easily just yesterday. But not today. Not today, no. Oh yeah, the spider bot. These things are a menace. Too late. I will not be taking chances, taking my chances as long as that thing is there. So as long as... Yeah, again, I need to wait for the spider ball to go away. Oh no. Missed again. That guy's dead. Now to avoid the spider bot. I'm just gonna wait right here. Wait for it to pass. Thank you. Let us pick this up. Move on ahead. Use the bridge key. We'll need that to cross the section. Climb up. And this is essentially a very long section in the game, is what it is. So basically we need to enter the waterfall. I'm so hungry. Right, I need to unequip that. Stand up and then I can drop down. Not before that though. Yeah, so there's like this entrance behind the waterfall. You can see like the outline just barely. I mean, I'm having difficulties seeing it, to be honest. You can see it more prominently at the lower end, bottom right corner. There are no enemies up ahead. But there is this trap that we best avoid. Thank you. And up ahead there are a few of our friends that will be providing us with essential stuff. But they also sort of make it difficult for us to exit from the place. You must be the chosen one. Take this potion. Thank you, friend. Power to the Androthi. Have you seen our brother? Yes, he's working in the mines. Thank you. Take this key. Thank you, friend. So, I've done all this. Thing is, these guys will make you wait. Because I'm waiting for the red guy to go away. Yeah, now I can jump up. Otherwise, Kyle will just enter a conversation with the other guy. Which is not what we want. There's the bridge key. Actually, we have like a spare bridge key. We'll need that up ahead. Time to go back through the waterfall. Go back up there. Hopefully we don't fall. Unlike last time. So yeah, like I was saying, if the graphics seem a little different, it's because I'm using this version of DOSBox called DOSBox Staging. I sort of got advised by one of you guys to start using it. Oh, that actually works. Let me hide away. The reason that I need to take this guy out is because he drops a bomb. And we need this bomb to proceed ahead. So apparently we can jump over them just fine. No issues whatsoever. That's one shot. Missed. Accidentally press the up button again. Missed again. I'll slowly get better at it. I hope. Oh no. Thank you for dying. So this is the levity that we need to get ahead. We'll get past the next section anyway. Let me just go ahead and consume that. Yeah, thank you. Whoops, yeah. If only I could steal a levitator. Well, I have stolen one. Although, I don't know why you might want one. I have one though. And this is why we need the bridge key. We could have made our descent safer, probably. Oh wait, that guy has something. Yeah, the bomb. We probably need it a bit. So this game doesn't unnecessarily give you resources. If the game is giving you resources, it's because you are going to need them. Looks like we're gonna have to do another running jump. Especially if we want to keep our health. Ouch. That did not work out. Time to take this bridge key back. Because no need to keep things. I thought I jumped. I guess not. Well, we are going to have to make do with whatever amount of health we currently have. Cool. Alright, time to head back towards the entrance. And we stand right here. Oops. Right. Yeah, this is how you use it. We can talk to this guy, but he uses drones. Yeah, and as soon as we get through the show, we'll meet a fellow Androthi. Who looks a lot like us in more than one way. And he's gonna hand us, like, a very powerful shotgun. Word travels fast of your deeds to defeat Sarlac. Take this weapon, friend. It was stolen from a guard. It is more powerful than what you're carrying. I will remember those that helped in Sarlac's defeat. Farewell. Right then. Issue is, I hardly have any health right now. But the previous time around, I actually went left. This time around, I want to try going right, just to see what's there. Curse Sarlac. You and I both, my friend. Oh no. That is not what I wanted to. There's a bridge key there? Actually, I can, like, use the bridge key right here. Oh, wait. That needs a different kind of key. Alright. We're heading back up then. I am playing this game like a dumbass right now. Pretty sure that I'm probably gonna get killed pretty soon. So this game is definitely difficult. So as you can see, there's like a guy right there on the other side. And this guy chained up here is gonna, well, pretty much die. There's no way to do that. That is not what I wanted to do. And we are almost dead. Missed. So yeah, like I was saying, one of you guys gave me the advice to use that, like, DOSBox staging, because apparently it makes the graphics look prettier. And that is essentially what I'm trying to do here. Give it that more vintage aesthetic. I do feel like it made, like, a huge difference to shading. Got him. This game can be responsive. Wait, he doesn't have to cock his gun anymore. So basically we could technically discharge two shots at a time. Couldn't we? Now I see a ledge down there, which is something that I want to check out first, before I jump the gap. Yeah, not much here, just like a fail-safe area for us. Except we don't really have a choice. If we fail this, we will not... Whoops. Time to retry then. Get this guy set. Time to make a run for it. Okay, we made it without dying, which is a good thing, which is always a good thing. I think we should be able to make it to the other side. I quickly want to check out what's down there though. Nothing. I think I did check it out even the last time around. Now, here's the issue. This guy's just gonna stand right there. Maybe we could try something here. Yep, that seems to have worked. That guy's nothing though. We can probably talk to this guy. Cool, this terrible life. We did free him. I suppose we didn't exactly need to take him out there. I guess that's why we were headed there then. Alright. Oh shit. I pressed the use key accidentally. I'll take my time with this. There are instances when they hold after firing is when you should be firing at them. So you can't exactly fire at them all willy-nilly all the time. I quickly want to check out if there is something down there. Nope, just a way back up. That's it. I wonder how they even nailed people to the wall at that point. Over there. He probably has the other key that we were looking for. Yep, the iron key. Might as well since we don't exactly need it for anything else. Now how do we get to the other side is what I wonder. Can we like make it? I think so, yeah. I suppose we were overcomplicating things for ourselves back there. Oh, so that's why it exists, I see. Oh well, we need to play this next section a little carefully. That's all we have to do, nothing else. I wish I could have saved more of my Androthi brothers from dying. But oh well, it is what it is. Now to make it to this end here, and what does this guy say? Curse Sarlac. Yes, curse him indeed. That guy got hit. Too late. He got hit again. Careful. Yep, that actually works. That actually works very nicely. Should just be able to, like, jump across the gap here without any issues. Although first I want to go ahead and collect whatever this is. Before it disappears behind the waterfall and there's like two wasp bombs for us. I see grabbable ledges, but I don't know if I want to go for them or not. I do believe I checked it out last time around. Yeah, there's nothing here. Wait, is there like a door? No, there isn't. There's a door there though. Which is something that I do wish to check out. Okay, this is gonna be... Luckily I haven't hit my fellow Androthi yet. Cool. Did not try discharging multiple shots and that succeeded. If you're caught, you will be punished. No shit, genius. Interesting. Could it be? Are you the chosen one? Why does it feel like the starting area here? Maybe this is where we have to go. I'm not certain. Okay, that thing does not get all the way towards us, which is good to know. I'm just gonna wait right here. Let it pass before I make my move. Now here's the thing, I do not want to engage him from that distance at all. Oh no. I hurt myself. Yep, that is exactly why I did not want to engage him from that distance. And there's no other way for us to harm him without, getting there. Although I suppose that is an optional area, so... Someday our people will be free. Someday indeed. Do I really need to get him? Hi. Pretty sure you have something of value here. A gate key. Probably something that we'll need later on. What does this guy have to say though? The laser fields keep us trapped. It is hopeless. Alright. This is a long section. This is a very long section. Challenging and long. Let me go ahead and use this wasp bomb then. On this guy, I mean. Dodge this, you troop. He does have something, and it's a hover bomb. Not a wasp bomb, but a hover bomb. I hope that will be enough for our use up ahead. Yeah, I'm not gonna take my chances with that thing though. Especially given the low health that I have right now. Absolutely not. So basically I had to come here to get the gate key. And that's pretty much it. Did I talk to you? Yeah. If you're caught, you will be punished. I know, son. I know. So there are two paths here. One of them goes upstairs. I don't think I need this. Over there anymore, at least. Okay. Oh, I see. I see. Interesting. Alright. We'll do that then. At least this next section has no enemies. So that's good. I suppose. In a way. Let me come all the way over here and use this hover bomb. Because I feel like I might just be damaging myself otherwise. Good thing I did that. Otherwise I might have just been caught up in the explosion. And got my ass handed to me. So I saw no enemies over here. In this section at least. Is that a boss? But he seems like an Androthi. Oh wait, that's the guy who teleported us at the beginning of the game. Kyle, it is good to see you again. Who are you? I'm Galadriel. Don't you remember me? Said the elf-looking fellow. Was it you who sent me to Earth? Yes, and it was I who brought you back. Your destiny is at hand. You must find the seer one hand. If you fail in your quest, all will be lost. I will help you as best I can. Go with speed. Oh hey!